All right, this is Bay 4, our stage 2. Shooter will start in box A, rifle loaded with a magazine of only 10 rounds. All reloads will be on their person. There is no pistol on this stage and it is not allowed to be used, even in the event of a malfunction. At buzzer, shooter will engage paper targets downrange until the rifle runs dry. Shooter may not reload until the rifle runs dry. Once shooter is satisfied with their paper target engagements, they will run to position 2, which is around the side here, and hit 2 steel targets that are about 50 yards away with 1 hit each. Standard scoring on paper. Anything less than 1 hit on each target will be scored as a miss penalty.
Hey.
Go. Here we see the gamer preparing for his stage.
Trying to figure out if I can actually see through my irons.
What does it dial down
in the box?
Ready?
Shooter, El Lodo!
He can supposedly have his iron sights, but, you know, supposedly.
Are you ready, O?
I haven't tried, but...
Octum!
It's... Yeah.
Mierda!
All right, so that was stage 4, but for us, our second stage of the day.
Yep.
So it's essentially a CQB thing. There's a bunch of paper at like 25 yards.
Real? Oh, not even. Some of it was like 5 yards.
Maybe the farthest away one.
Yeah.
25 yards. And then you're moving through windows.
Yep.
And then you had to haul butt over to some steel and get some 50-yard steel targets.
Yep.
Okay. How'd it go?
Not great. Okay. So I was debating, what's the best way to actually shoot something really close with this combination of sights? And the answer is there is no good solution. I actually used my irons on the first target, which sort of worked, and then I tried to go to the next one, and no, couldn't.
Would the irons be more usable if that bolt wasn't so much in the way?
A little bit.
But not they'd still be bad, right?
Hugely, they're still bad. So I went to using the scope instead, and I had 7 minus 1 penalties for shots that were low, and the reason being, just like on the last stage, where the man-sized target at 100 yards filled up a big chunk of the optic, on this... When I was on target with this scope, all I saw was brown. It was just a sea of brown. And so I put the gun in the brown and pulled the trigger a bunch, and I know that I have a significant bore offset issue.
Yeah, it's like a foot.
But I can't do anything about it if I can't actually tell what part of the paper target I'm aiming at.
It's not a foot, but it's not that far off from a foot.
No, it's about as bad as anything.
Now that said, there's no BDC stadium lines either. It's just a line coming up.
Yep, so, I've got actually wind stadia.
You got that.
I don't have elevation.
So, you know, if you've got elevation stadia lines, you can actually learn to have a good dope zero for close range with a scope, because you know 400 or 600 meters is your holdover at 7 yards.
Right.
This doesn't give you that.
In theory, I suppose I could adjust the actual elevation knob, but no.
Don't be turning those knobs. That's crazy talk. leave that alone.
Yeah.
But I would say if you had lines, you'd help, or you could train to learn where the pole needs to be.
Yeah.
So anyways, because of the bore offset, you had 7 low hits.
Yeah. So I had a total time of like 40 seconds compared to your total time.
No, you had 39 second run with 7 minus 1. So 47. You had 40, yeah, 46.
And I had one other issue, which was had a malfunction. My last round in the magazine, the bolt didn't quite go all the way into battery. And I should have, I went and reloaded. I noticed it, so I didn't try and fire. But I should have cleared the mouth, pulled the mag, cleared the mouth, and then reloaded. Instead, I swapped mags, tried to reload, realized I couldn't, cleared it. That cost me a couple seconds.
Now, this is your first example of that occurring to you?
First time I've really had a problem with it.
However, as we mentioned before, we've heard of spring pressure being insufficient in these guns.
Yeah.
Maybe you need an 8mm Lebel case in your buttstock
assembly. Possibly.
That's the stuff that was happening to me, and that's where that 8mm Lebel case actually fixed it.
Yeah.
So, at any rate, everything went great for me. 29 seconds, 3 minus 1s.
That's one of the best scores we had in our squad.
I think it is my, to this point. It might be the best score on the squad so far. So, you know, the sight picture is horrible, but when the gun's running, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. So, I'm turning in good scores today.
I'm still enjoying the rifle. Just so far, we've had 2 stages where the setup, the scope, and the bipod really isn't optimal for
Do you see a future where you would go with just an L instead of an LV?
Probably not. I think if I'm going to take a rifle that's obscure and weird like this, I want the one that goes to 11 with the obscureness, the scope.
We'll get more into that in conclusion.
What I'll do is just shoot this in places where that scope works with me instead of against me.
I think someone ran up an artillery round. Anyways, we'll get more into that in conclusion.
No. All right, let's move on to the next stage.
Yep.